with all the hysteria going around with this virus having to impact the world, I said to myself, why not go back and actually play a game that I used to play many, many years ago, as I do want to welcome you guys back to a very awesome video here today, which this is a game called Plague Inc. Now, we're going to infect the entire planet, but we're going to be doing it in a zombies kind of way. So let's not waste any more time. This is going to be my virus, and I want to see what I'm going to do here. Let's see. We're going to go on. We're going to play on Brutal because I want to see how far we can go. Now, the name of this virus, now, ironically enough, I want to make it the Rage Virus from 28 Days/28 Weeks Later because I always figured those movies were fantastic because the zombies would run, and it would really make the situation that much more unpredictable. So, welcome to my scenario. Guys, by the way, if you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, slap a big fat like down below, and also tune in through the entire video because I want to have an intellectual conversation about what you guys would do in a zombie-like scenario. So, here we go. Let's just go on ahead and choose our country. So, I think I want to kick things off with China. We're going to have the virus start in China for obvious reasons. So, the Rage Virus begins in China. So, I'm going to go on ahead and fast forward this real quick. Okay, so the world population right now, it is, let's see, 4 people are infected among 7,100,000,000. Mass panic over 3D printed robotic juicers, that's stupid. Okay, so I want to also increase and manipulate my virus in terms of transmission and its symptoms and whatnot and its abilities to survive. So this virus is going to be, I think, unlike anything else. Can I evolve this? Okay, perfect. So, the cold water systems tap water. So, if you drink tap water, you're going to get the Rage Virus, alright? So, I want to go in ahead and just see how many people we can infect here. Now, you guys can get this on mobile, you guys can get this on Steam. It's a pretty fun-ass game. So far, 51 people, 66, 100 people are infected. This is perfect. Alright, so, the virus is starting to spread. And we have over almost 1,000 people that are infected. So, the question today, right, is let's say if a zombie apocalypse broke out, what would you guys do? Like, in a case to where zombies are able to run, they're able to, you know, just travel in packs, like we've seen in Dawn of the Dead, what would you guys do? Look at that, 14,000 people infected. And it's only in China so far. So, let's go back to the disease. Now, I want to make this disease spread via physical contact. So, if you shake hands or if you spank your monkey, you're definitely going to get the virus. Now, also, I think birds. I think birds are a great way to do this, and I would do bats. I really would do bats, but I don't think I have enough points right now. Do I have points? Oh, I do. Okay. So, ironically enough, bats actually spread the disease that much more. All right. So, almost 50,000 people are infected. Look at this. The number is rising. Now, the thing is right now, global warming, hot countries getting hotter, of course, because all the ice is melting in the world. So, right now, I think the goal is to try to get this virus. Oh, there it is. It spreads into Russia. Oh, damn. Damn, look at, yo, this virus is spreading. 6 million people infected. All right, so this is more infectious than TB. Okay, so I'm going to have to really pay attention here. Look at China. China's getting destroyed. 37 million people. World menu contains useful data. All right, so Japan just got infected, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so now that, all right, so people are beginning to catch this virus. And it's more infectious than HIV, dude. All right, so Australia just got hit. Oh, I think Mexico's about to get hit. Yep, Mexico just got infected. All right, so being the fact that transmission is starting to spread, now it's time for the symptoms to kick in. So we have, what do we have here? We have obsession, severe damage to the orbital cortex triggers OCD. All right, I'm gonna hold off on that. What is this? Cryopathic reanimation? Alright, so reanimation for sure. What is this? These scientific words are crazy. Partial nutrient development triggers in the lungs. Alright, sure, we're gonna go ahead and do that. This virus is going to cause rashes and coughing. I don't want to make this virus too severe right now because there's still so much that I need to do. So let's just go on ahead and see what's about to happen. Oh, damn. All right, so the Rage Virus begins to reanimate the dead. Oh, here we go. Now we have zombies. So new minor disease spreading. Nah, man. Okay, so this disease is really, really starting to spread all over, I think. So what am I supposed to do right now? Shit, let me just go on ahead and infect these countries real quick. China shuts down its borders. Yeah, because China right now is getting hit the hardest. I'm not sure if the rage virus is in America right now, to be honest. The world hasn't started on a cure just yet, so let me see. What can I do? I have no idea how to upgrade this damn virus to something severe. But right now, you guys can see here that we have 20% of the population has been infected, right? So we have Indonesia, America, Saudi Arabia, the UK, Iran, Russia, Australia, Japan. All these places are infected. So 1,434,000,000 people are infected, while 5 billion are still intact. So now the virus is starting to spread in a way to where everyone's going to be catching it. So abilities. So this thing, I will allow it to survive in the cold, and I will also allow it to survive in the heat. Now, also in terms of this, the fake sleepers, yes, fake sleeper cells, and it has bacterial resistance. So yes, my virus is going to destroy everyone. So in a worst case scenario like this, I genuinely want to get your thoughts as to what the heck you guys would do, because so many people would panic, I think. I think especially if this virus, oh, here we go. Especially if this virus spreads the way it does right now. First death in China. Okay, so the zombies are starting to eat and kill everybody. Okay, so the world right now is in shambles. We have over 700 zombies, while millions, I think billions, are infected. So now, I would argue, the zombie virus is about to kick in heavy, because certain countries that were safe are no longer safe. The world has started a resistance for the virus itself. I need to mutate this virus. I honestly think that a lot of people do want to see like a zombie outbreak happen in real life. Like, people are all definitely all for it, but they're all for it so as long as it doesn't really affect their business or it affects them per se, right? So let me see here. Damn. Rage virus turning people into zombies. Faced with overwhelming evidence, governments confirmed that the rage virus can trigger pathological aggression in corpses, but say the situation is under control. Yeah, right. That's what the government does best. They lie to people about this. Okay, so over 50,000 people have been killed. Now the more infectious than the common cold. Hell yeah, it is. Now, if you guys have seen 28 days, 28 weeks later, those zombies are freaking scary, dude. Like, it's terrifying, I think. So what I'm gonna do right now is I want to make this a bit more lethal. So reanimate recently deceased. Yes, the dead are gonna come back to life. Transmission options. Oh, I'm sorry for this, guys, but you're going to get infected if you have dogs. I'm sorry for this. Infected dog bites. Yes, like rabies. Dude, this virus is going to destroy. Look at that, Australia. We have what? Peru just got infected. Oh boy. Okay, so we have 3 million zombies. That's a lot of freaking zombies, dude. Let's go ahead and check our graph here. So we have 2,974,000,000 people infected. We have 8,800,000 zombies, and over 340,000 people have died. So this is the current status of the rage virus. Now, Bolivia, the Caribbean, Canada's safe, Greenland is safe, Iceland is safe. So all these places, I think, are safe for now, until I infect them. So let's just see how this goes. But in a case to where zombies like this actually infect and destroy the world, what I want to know is, what would you guys do per se? Oh, Canada just got infected. All my Canadian brethren, you guys just got destroyed. The USA is the leading global cure effort. Oh, damn it. All right, so we're gonna have to destroy the states, bro, because they're trying to halt our virus, man. Our virus, our zombie infection is going to be destroyed by the states, man. Okay, the ZEMCOM is set up a new base. All right, so I'm going to have to, let's see here real quick. We have over 700 million zombies, dude. We have more people infected than healthy people in the world. So as you guys can see here, I'm going to have to infect the remainder of Africa and Iceland. So we're going to have to make this... we're gonna have to make this virus adapt to the cold even more, but it's only resistant to so much. So what is this? Genetic swap that costs 55 freaking points, dude. What about transmission? Let's see here. Saliva, yes. If you're making out, you're gonna get the virus. With rats, yes. I mean, there's a lot of countries like India and stuff that have lots of like rats and whatever. So symptoms, let's see here. What is this? Sneezing. Oh yeah, if you sneeze, you have the virus. Oh, look at this map though. Holy God, Africa. The remainder of Africa is about to be destroyed. Look at the world, bro. The zombies are infecting everything. Did Greenland shut down its borders? You sons of bitches. Yep, they're all here. Here come the hordes. Yep, the hordes are starting. Look at that. Zombies destroyed the Philippines. Zombies have hunted down the last group of survivors in the Philippines. There is one left alive. Without food, the zombies will begin to starve. Holy crap, so the entire Philippines is gone. To all my homies in the Philippines, I'm sorry, but it just had to have been done. Look at the world right now. Like, I think, what would be the best case and worst case scenarios if this actually happened, guys? I genuinely want to get your thoughts and feedback in the comment section below, because if something like this actually happened, then I don't really think, holy crap, I don't really think the world's governments would be able to contain this, because this would be, look at this, extreme cold wave in Sweden. Man, PewDiePie is screwed out there. All right, let's check this. Wow, only 13% of the world exists. There are only 900 million people that are healthy, 800,000 that are infected, almost 3 billion zombies, with 2 billion people dead. Now, the Caribbean, Iceland, Greenland, Morocco, Madagascar, Guyana, and New Zealand. Those are the only places that are not infected. All right, so now it's time to finalize our symptoms. Transmission, we are going to, can we evolve anything else? Yes, general saliva. Oh, hell yeah, blue. Dude, blood-sucking mosquitoes, hell yeah. Blood, yes. Symptoms. All right, here we go. Now, this is where things are going to get a little crazy. We're going to upgrade our genetic swap. We're going to have genetic herding. We have no DNA. We have no DNA points left. Okay, so, oh, damn, the cure is 25% completed. Now, the virus, I think, it's starting to really impact the world. I mean, the zombies are starting to also die off because of lack of food. Oh, there we go. West Africa just got hit. If you guys just recall, we weren't able to get West Africa at all. Look at the zombies, though, man. The last, I'm telling you, Greenland and Iceland right now are the only safe havens for this place. That's about it. The virus, I mean, the cure for the virus is just about 30% completed. So, and the virus is continuously growing. All right, so the world right now, what I need to do is infect Greenland and Iceland, like, to the T. Let's go ahead and check our map here. Look at this. There's only 170 million people left alive. So if you're living like on a remote island, you're safe. We have 4 billion people that have died, 1 billion zombies remaining. This virus is really, really going out there. So let me see real quick. We need to go out there. We need to destroy the Icelands. But that's going to be a little difficult because unleash the horde. Hell yeah, dude. We're unleashing all types of hordes. Now, transmission, I think symptoms, let's go back to symptoms real quick. So, what can I do here? Can I evolve? I can actually devolve things, but I don't want to do that. Okay, so I need more points to evolve this, because then the virus is going to become even more ruthless. Alright, so, let's DNA used. Okay, so daily infections. Okay, so people aren't getting as infected as much, but the virus's overall impact is, damn, ZCOM destroyed in Poland. All the zombies in Poland just wrecked everything, dog. Alright, so we're gonna have to desperately try to, because the death toll is, like, it's reaching. But we need to infect the islands. Like, Madagascar has no zombies. Like, Madagascar, you know, all these places, New Guyana, whatever the hell it's called, that has no zombies. It's like, bruh. So, I definitely, Greenland and Iceland, we need to infect those. Rotting zombies wash up on beaches. That's not good at all. Oh, Madagascar just got infected. Madagascar just got infected. Holy crap. And this virus right now, like, obviously the US did not do a good job in trying to, like, contain this thing. This is insanity. Okay, so only 62 million people remain. We wiped out quite a bit. It's those secure places, like those islands and stuff, that are really not infected here. Alright, let's see. I mean, you guys are probably thinking, like, damn, man, like, well, why'd you gotta go and do that, Alex? So I'm just like, alright, man, well, it is what it is. They shut down all of the places for, like, travel and whatnot. 166 million zombies, 24 million infected. Alright, so we're gonna have to get this virus out there. Transmission, I don't think there's any other way, to be honest. Unless it's physical contact, I'll do that. And can I evolve the sewage systems? Yes. What is this? Contaminated seawater. Oh, hell yeah. That would be a great way. Because if that virus were to go out there and contaminate the water, then I'm fairly certain that maybe it could reach Greenland, it can reach Iceland, and then from there, we would be able to infect the last remaining places, because I really need, what is this? Oh, yes. Yes, definitely need to go over here. Can I infect this place by any chance? Damn it. I don't think there's anything I can do. Wait a minute. Oh, yeah. Hold on. Yes. We're gonna go. Okay, so hopefully that is going to infect. Let me see. I definitely need to infect those two places right there. The zombies are about to die off. It's been about a year, I think, in this world that created this massive panic. So, either way, guys. Damn. Yeah. I mean, listen, I could easily destroy the remainder of the world if I wanted to right now. I'm just, infection right now, how many more people are infected? 50 million. Yeah, we have 8 million more infected and 93 million zombies. So I'm not trying to have these people recover from that. But then again, I really doubt, look at the US. Like, there's no zombies in America because all of America is destroyed. All of China is destroyed. Like, look at this. Zombies in all different kinds of places in the world are gone. So that's what made, wait a minute, there's no zombies in Greenland, I'm trying to see if I can infect whatever place that I can, because I need my zombies to, let me see, symptoms, transmission, all right, abilities, I think I'm going to have to, can I devolve that, or maybe, what else can I devolve here, let me see if I can actually devolve these bats. I actually lost points. No, damn it. I'm trying to infect the remainder of the world and it's not working in my favor right now. Let me just fast forward this real quick. Yeah, so the zombies are starting to die. The cure for this virus is starting to develop. I think Canada has a big problem out there. Dude, Canada got a huge problem because you still got, like, you got 29 million zombies that are out there doing their own thing. So that's definitely not, you know, good for Canada. I think Canada is the only place right now. Weeping Sore is mutated, yes. So I think Canada is the only place that has, like, a huge zombie problem. Because, like, I mean, more people are starting to die. But this cure might be a thing. I swear to God, they might actually come up with a cure for this thing. Let me just fast forward real quick. Yeah. So far, yeah, the world's zombie population is going down, but the only thing that I really want is I need to destroy these two islands up here, but it's so hard for me to get up there because, you know, climate or whatever. So those two nations, man, like, they really close themselves off. Let me see, drug-resistant abilities can slow the cure. I know that, and I'm trying to see what I can do to destroy the remainder of the world. I mean, either way, if our virus gets destroyed, then we still had such a significant impact in the world, in the fact that, like, we destroyed everything. Like, there's nothing, like, there's literally nothing left. So let's just see, zombies are starting to die off, but then again, the virus, the cure for the virus is starting to, you know, come into play here. All right, so zombies, look at this number, it keeps fluctuating. And the cure is just about, oh, damn it, the cure is just about 85% completed. Oh, look at that. The rage virus had been eradicated. What? The rage virus is gone? Ah, defeat. Ah, damn it. All right, let's just see here. So the plague has been defeated. What is my? Ah, damn. That was insane though. Like, we destroyed so many of the world's population. I want you guys to look at this real quick. So in less than a year, this thing was, like, destroying everything out there. So, and this is just, like, a little recap as to where, because the complexity of this thing is insane. But either way, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys want to see more content like this, then let me know in the comment section below. Again, thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, be sure to go on ahead and slap a big fat like down below. Hit that subscribe button, everybody. Tune back in for the next video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Take it easy, guys. Peace!